Okay, now moving on to college, guys. So he'll tell you about his college life.
Yeah, so...
Okay, before that, So as you heard, he enjoyed his hostel life a lot, but I never got an opportunity to experience the hostel life. I didn't, really want it then. I didn't really want to be in a hostel then. But now, I don't really regret, but I should have been in a hostel at least for 1 or 2 years, right? I would have learned a lot more things. I would have learned to be on my own. I would have learned to, you know, take care of myself in a better way, to be independent, to not depend on anyone. After marriage only, I realized that I don't know to do a lot of things like ironing clothes. And I was not used to being organized.
I fill up this bag. Washing clothes, ironing clothes, washing vessels.
Washing clothes nobody does because the washing machine does that, okay? I know to throw clothes into the washing machine. And washing vessels, of course, like I used to help my mom now and then with washing the vessels before marriage. But after marriage, when it became a regular task, it was really hitting me hard. I was not able to do that. And as about ironing clothes, I really didn't know how to even hold a shirt.
Tying a sari.
Yo, don't even tell me. How to even hold a shirt or how to even fold a pant to iron or really, I had no idea. So maybe if I was in a hostel, I would have had better exposure. I really miss that now. At least I would have had something to tell you guys. My school life was like a total nil now.
That's so sweet. But she would have lost her innocence. That's one of the things I love about her. She's so, so innocent. See that halo over her head now?
Ding.
Yeah, and my regret was I have always studied in a boys' school, I think. So boys' school, boys' hostel, like in boys'
school. He studied in a boys' school, still he managed to somehow woo me and make girls fall for him. Imagine if he had to study in a co-ed school. You don't have to regret all that. It's good that you studied in a boys' school.
And again, boys' college and boys' hostel. And then again, on a ship with
full men. Good. I'm happy. His life is full of men. I'm happy.
Sound bad, didn't it?
Okay, now let's move on to his college life, the course he took, and about his maritime field.
So I cannot sit in one place. I have... My mom used to tell me I have springs up my backside and all that. So, yeah, so office job was never meant for me. I did try a call center, but I could not sit and talk over the phone for so long. I'm not that kind of a guy. So anyway, so I did try for NDA and I didn't complete that entrance exam. Before that, I got into my college. So what happened one morning was we came for admissions in Chennai and my father said, okay, look at this newspaper, there's an ad about a college. And I was like, sleeping and I was lazy. I was like, okay, let the results come and then we can go and see and all that. He said, no, let's go try this college. So I wanted to be a pilot. Okay, so either that or it used to be Navy. So an Air Force pilot or Navy, these were my ambitions, and NDA was like pretty far away for me. So we tried this Merchant Navy, this college. That's what the ad said in the paper. And there was this university called, it was a college then, now it's a university. It's Academy of Maritime Education and Training. That's in Kanathur. It's in Uttandi, near Mayajal. Everyone knows Mayajal, so it's pretty close to that. You would see a naval college over there. Yeah, that's the one. So I had a lot of friends over there. First, real good friends I've made over there. And so went for admissions, got selected, and 3 years of college. And got to meet her during those days. Over to you.
That's all. What is the course that you took in college?
Okay, I took a BSc in Nautical Science. That was the
that
3 years course.
That is for officers, not for marine engineers. So for marine engineers, which course are they supposed to take?
There are several courses. If you have done mechanical engineering or some other engineering, and if you want to do a marine diploma, there are diploma courses like that way. Otherwise, there's higher nautical diploma, that is 1 year in India, 1 year in UK. If you want a proper engineering course, there's BE in marine engineering and there's BTech in marine technology.
Yeah, so if you take BE in marine engineering, you cannot become an officer. You guys have to take BSc in nautical science to become an officer.
Yeah, engineers.
That confusion is always there.
Engineers are also considered as officers, but engineers don't get to become captains. So I wanted to be a captain. I wanted to move around a lot. And engineers are real good people and we work with them and they are quite the brains of it. But
they work hand in hand, but it's just that you can't become the captain.
Yeah, we love to command. So if you want to command, then you have to take a course of BSc in Nautical Science.
Yeah, and currently your rank is?
Currently, I'm one step away from becoming a captain, and so I'm a chief officer. So over to you. Yeah, so Shidal goes in love. what do you call it? What therapy is that called? Yeah, she's good at making. She's the only one who laughs for my jokes. For example.
And he's the only one who makes me laugh all the time. I laugh for anything that he does.
Especially
even if you see our challenges. If the challenge is for like 20 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, I'll be laughing in the video. Only for 5 minutes, I'll be speaking something. Because anything he does makes me laugh. And I totally love it. That's one thing I love about him. Everybody loves a partner who makes you laugh, right? So that's what I love the most about him.
Yeah, whenever I get hurt, she just goes off over it. Yeah? She just can't stop laughing if I get hurt. She just loves it. I don't know why.
Okay, so coming back to my college life, I studied in Crescent Engineering College, Vandalur. So we used to actually stay in Santhome. So Santhome to Vandalur is how many kilometers?
18 kilometers,
I think. So my college bus used to come, and I used to board my college bus at around 7 to 7:30 in the morning and go to college, and then come back home by 7 or 7:30, I guess. So it was a whole day gone in traveling itself. But it was a Muslim college, and it was very comfortable for me, and I made a lot of friends in college, and it was great. I had some really, you know, my closest friends and my besties now are from my college only. I don't have, you know, touch with any of my school friends now, as of now. But my besties and my closest friends are from college, and I'm in touch with them even now, and I totally love them. So that's what I love the most about my college, because in school, I didn't have many friends. I didn't enjoy my school life. So in college, it was completely the opposite. I completely enjoyed my college life, and I really enjoyed the attention that I got in college. I was quite popular in college. I didn't want to really, you know, show off now, but that is also one of the, you know, aspects of college that people enjoy, right? Like if you go to college, you want some attention. Everybody enjoys attention. So I enjoyed all the attention that I got from my seniors, from my juniors, from my batchmates. I was always, you know, the one of the most happening girls in college. So I got a lot of attention anywhere I went, so I enjoyed that thoroughly. I got a lot of proposals in college, something that did not happen in school.
Oh,
but
no!
That is something I enjoyed in college. I enjoyed getting a lot of proposals, of course. I miss my college days. That was fun. My college was complete. So boys don't generally get any proposals, I guess. So he does not know what it feels like. That's why he's giving you all these funny expressions, poor souls. So 4 years of my college life, I thoroughly enjoyed, but he was there right from the beginning, right from my school days, from 12th standard, I think he was there, and we were like close buddies for 2 years, and then we got committed when I was in third year or something. I accepted his proposal. Out of all the boys in my college, out of all the proposals that I got, I chose someone outside my college. I chose someone outside my community. I really don't know how that happened. But I was totally in love with him, and something in him was not present in everybody else in all their proposals. The way he proposed to me, or the way he spoke to me, or whatever it was not present in any of the other boys. So I didn't actually choose him. I fell for him eventually. So it was like that. So the love part was also happening during my college day. So I was enjoying that as well thoroughly. He used to drop me in college, pick me up from college. He used to take me to places. He used to always be with me whenever he's here. So whenever he's on board, it's very difficult to, you know, like really keep in touch with each other. So yeah, so coming back to my studies, I did BE Computer Science in college. That was my UG. And that's it, guys. 4 years just passed like that. It was fun. Even the studies part I enjoyed a lot. It was not as boring as my school, because in school I was completely dead. But in college, since I was enjoying the entire college atmosphere, the study part was also good. Yeah, so I graduated in 2012, right? Yeah, so I graduated in 2012. And to be honest, I didn't actually want to do BE engineering. After I completed school, I told my parents I wanted to do hotel management, or I wanted to do fashion designing. Yeah, I told my parents I wanted to do fashion designing or hotel management. Actually, I had an idea to go for an air hostess training, but I didn't tell that to my parents. I just wanted to start with the hotel management and fashion designing, but they completely denied and they actually pushed me into this BE computer science. They tried to, you know, do a lot of dramas and convince me to get into this, and they didn't give me any option also. They just gave me an option for college, like they gave me an option for Crescent and for another Muslim college. Both were Muslim colleges, but I chose Crescent, and I was not very excited about the course. If I had to do fashion designing or if I had to do hotel management, maybe it would have been very useful for me. See, eventually, no matter what you study, you can only do what your heart follows, right? If your parents are stopping you from doing something, that's not gonna really stop you. You will find a way out of it and you will get into the things that you really want to do. So that's what happened with me. So even though I did BE engineering, my heart was never there, and at last, now I'm doing what I love. I'm doing YouTube. I'm in front of the camera. My dad told me I should never be in any field in which I meet people or face people, or, you know, the customer handling jobs, so something like that. He never wanted me to get exposed in such kind of jobs or such kind of fields. But at last, I'm here on media, on YouTube. So this is what life is all about. You just have to follow your heart, guys. That is where your happiness is, and that is where you're going to grow. If you're going to do something for the sake of others, you'll never grow, you'll never continue.
Life is too short, guys. Life is too short.
Yeah, so you guys have to value your happiness more than anybody else's happiness.
Unless you
are
happy.
In that case, you guys have to be a little selfish, otherwise you're never going to be happy, and others are also never going to be happy with, no matter what you do, no matter how much you try to please them, they're never going to be happy with you. So at least value your own happiness and do something for yourself.
Glad I married you.
Okay, so this is all about our college life
and the last one, huh?
Yeah, now let's get back to work.
During college itself, I got selected in a company, and the whole batch was placed in good companies during those days. Now it's flooded, the market's flooded again, but yeah. So my company is Fleet Management Limited, and I've been with them for 12 years now, since 2008, and it's a home away from home, I would say. Another beautiful life I had, met wonderful mentors who guided me in the right direction, and I met people who taught me tough lessons also, and it's not easy. It's not at all easy, because the worst part about shipping, which I realized, was there are no doctors on board, there are no police on board. So if you get into a trouble, you got to sort it out yourself. So that makes you tough, and
that makes you disciplined.
It gives you, it, life teaches you rough lessons sometimes. So yes, we've all crossed that stage. We've come to a very, we grew up to be men from boys, and that's where the whole learning part was. So whatever we learned in college, we learned to practically apply it on board, and we learned everything what we know now during those days. So there was 1 year of onboard training as a cadet, and then had to do a government exam and get the license. Just like how you get your driving license over here, you get your license to be a junior officer, and then I have to sail for some time as a junior officer, and then I get to be a senior officer in charge of navigation, stability, and other details to run the ship and all that. And next level is the master. The last level is the master. Currently, I'm sailing as a chief officer, and I'm comfortable with bulk carriers. I've worked on tankers, I've worked on container ships, but bulk carriers are slow and they're steady. So we get longer port stays, so I get to visit different countries, and I've been lucky enough to visit around 35 countries and had a beautiful time.
Only 35? I think more than that.
Okay, lost count of it. Okay, anyways, but there's no place like home. I love India, I don't know why. It's always good to come back home. Yes, and yeah. So out of the other places, I think Canada is the most beautiful place I've seen.
Oh my god, don't remind me of Canada. I loved Canada, even though I got to spend only 1 day in Canada. I just totally loved the atmosphere, I loved the people, the weather, the beauty, the tulips. The tulips were growing on the roadside. My god, so
she
beautiful.
Loves to travel.
I love to travel. So, about my work. So, after finishing college, I got placed in Wipro Technologies. It was a campus placement. I also got placed in Flextronics. So the call came at the same time and I went with Wipro, since it was a very renowned and known company for most of us. So I went with Wipro and I worked in Wipro for 6 years. So at the end of 5 years, Ryan was born and I was felicitated with a 5-year award. And after that, I was really struggling to balance my personal life with my child and my professional life. So I was getting promoted actually. I became the team lead and people were working under me. So at that point of time, I had some responsibility towards my team as well. I had to mentor them. I had to really, I had to be responsible for everything and I am answerable to everything. And especially I was working for a US project. So all my senior managers and everybody comes to work at night. In India it will be night and in US it will be in the morning. So I'll come back home from office and again I have to log in and work till 2 o'clock in the night. So that was becoming very difficult for me. That time my child was only about 8 or 9 months. I was still feeding him, so I had to feed him and put him to sleep and again log in and work, and then I have to sleep and again I have to get up in the morning and rush to office. It was becoming very tedious for me. And that time my husband was sailing, so there was no support at all. He would call me now and then and ask me, what did baby eat, what did baby do? And you know, I was not even in the right state of mind to answer such questions. So at the end of 6 years, I quit my job. And I was at home for 1 year after that, I think, without any job. And after that, somehow this YouTube popped up. We'll tell you how YouTube popped up. I started posting videos and I took it very lightly. Like, you know, I really didn't want it to be a profession. I just wanted it to keep me occupied, keep me entertained. I started posting videos now and then, not even regularly. But now since I have a number of followers and all you guys are showing such love and support, really, I've given it more thought, I've given it more interest, and now I'm posting videos regularly. This has become my profession now and I'm loving it. So this is about my career. It has been a roller coaster ride for me.
Got to visit a company once. It's a beautiful office which they have.
Yeah, Wipro campus is too good. Unlike other offices, Wipro has a very beautiful campus with a lot of greeneries all around. It almost looks like a park when you're out of the building. But in other offices, I've noticed that there are only buildings. There are no parks or there are no seats and all that. But in Wipro, you have fish ponds, you have fish tanks, you have like trees and benches and parks, and you have an organic spot where you actually dump the waste and make organic manure. You have all kinds of fruit trees and vegetable trees. You have curry leaf trees, you have sapota, mango, guava, so many other trees. So it's such a lovely campus. I enjoyed working there actually. 6 years is a very long time, right? I really enjoyed.
And then she now totally loves YouTube.
Yeah, I totally love YouTube and I'm not even thinking about going back to any office right now.
Yeah, it's stressful. I used to see
stressful and my child still needs me. He's only 3 now and he still has to learn to look after himself. So can't leave him alone and go out and work and bring that stress home and showing it on child and husband. It really won't work for me. And I'm not the kind of cool-headed person. So if I'm stressed out, I'll definitely pass on the stress to my child and my husband. So I'm a person like that. So I really don't want to do that. I want to have a peaceful life. I want to have some peace for myself. So it's best that I don't take any extra stress.
Yeah. Best. Happy wife, happy life, guys. Well, that's about us, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you do have any other questions for us, do mention it in the comment box below and we'll find some time to reply to you guys. Thank you very much for watching this video.
Thank you for supporting us and showing so much of love.
That's all that matters to us, guys. If every like, every comment, and if you do have time, click on the subscribe button and the bell icon.
Yeah, a lot of you are not getting notifications when we post our video. That's because you haven't clicked on the all bell icon. So when you click on the subscribe button, you get 3 options: none, personalized, or all. You have to click on the all notification button. Only then you will get all the notifications as soon as we post our video. So that's very important, guys. And if you are new to our channel and if you're continuing to watch our channel, to watch our faces every day, then please do subscribe to our channel, because in the analytics section we can see that a lot of people are watching our videos but they are not subscribed to our channel. So subscribing to our channel motivates us and we all become one family, right, when you subscribe to us. So please do subscribe. Take care, love you all, see you again in another interesting video. Take care, bye bye.
We have more challenges coming up for you, so stay tuned to our channel. See you guys, bye bye, take care, bye-bye.